superheroing days are over.
Hello friends, my name is Stevie Cade and welcome to Film Trigger. Thor, Love and Thunder, the trailer has finally dropped and we've waited a long time for this trailer because this movie's out in like a month-ish. I have a feeling I know what this trailer's gonna feel like. It's pretty much gonna be 80s the movie. That's not necessarily a bad thing. Taika Waititi kind of gave us that in Thor Ragnarok. But I'm also feeling like maybe 80s nostalgia might be running its course. So maybe this movie will do it for me, maybe not. Let's see if this trailer answers any of those questions and if it was worth the wait.
These hands were once used for battle. Now they're but humble tools for peace.
All right, so he's given up fighting.
I need to figure out exactly who I am.
All right, Guns N' Roses, 80s the movie, like I said. He looked like Forrest Gump when Forrest Gump was running there.
I want to choose my own path, live in the moment. My superheroing days are over.
Oh, is that Russell Crowe? Is that Zeus?
Remember what I told you. You ever feel lost?
Valkyrie.
Just look into the eyes.
Wearing a suit and tie at a regular job. Good for her.
Not me.
What? Just listening.
Milnor, I saw that in the toys. And Lady Thor. Or the Mighty Thor, as I think they're going to call her. Okay. All right, well, that was a trailer. So I'm really torn here because I really am excited for this movie. I'm super hyped about it. And this teaser trailer was just that. It was a teaser. It didn't give us anything, which made this reaction really boring because I really had nothing to say. It looks exactly like I thought it would look like. I really enjoy the fact that Thor's going through this journey. Who would have thought that out of all the Avengers characters, Thor is potentially going to have the biggest character development throughout the entire MCU? Then we got Lady Thor. There's two concepts that are running through my head of how this is going to work. Number one, they're going to go the cheap route and be like, oh, MCU, multiverse, this is Thor from a different world, and it's actually going to be himself. And then he can make love to himself in that weird sort of Loki sort of way. Or something happened in a movie that we haven't seen yet. Like, maybe there's going to be some explanation maybe in Multiverse of Madness that comes out about Jane and where she's been. I know in the comics, I think she had, like, cancer and she ended up picking up Milnor and it saved and it healed her cancer and blah, blah, blah. Milnor is another thing to discuss here because that is obviously the same Milnor that broke to pieces in Thor Ragnarok, which shouldn't be hard to find, because if nobody can lift Milnor, then it probably just stayed there in the grass until Thor came and picked up the pieces, or somebody who was worthy came and picked up the pieces. As for my excitement, I wish we would have gotten a full trailer. I think we've waited long enough. I'm not really more or less excited. It just gave me pretty much what I already thought this was. So at least I'm not disappointed. There's a positive. Let me know what you thought about this trailer in the comments below. Are you super hyped about this movie? Did this teaser do it for you? Or was it lackluster and you really have no interest in Thor and you kind of wish they'd just be done? Because I will admit, Thor has two sets of fans. You have the Thor fans that love the first two movies and not necessarily Ragnarok and moving forward. And then you have fans that love Ragnarok moving forward and not so much the older movies. I find myself right in the middle. Anyway, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Also, be sure to check out some more of my videos and live streams. And as always, stay trigger happy, my friends. Peace.